My name is Thomas. This will be the story about what happened to me over the last few days. Have you ever wondered what would happen when bad decisions make you lose your mind? It turns out this is happening to me. If someone were to read this, they would probably think I'm crazy. Maybe I am. I'm not even sure where to start, and I certainly don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my wife, Zoe. But let's start where it all began. 3 days ago, after a long day at work. It was an exhausting day at work. I just came back from the town. The town is only a 15-minute drive from here. Anyway, apart from this, it appeared to be an ordinary evening. Zoe and I bought this house about a year ago. You might wonder, why this place? Why so far from everything? Well, let's just say because both of us wanted to get away from it all. The city, the noise, everything. Just a quiet place for ourselves. Let me tell you something that makes this sleep paralysis even worse. I know this woman I just saw. No, it wasn't Zoe. It was Alice. Albeit a distorted and demonic version of her. Who is Alice? Well, you could say we've had a history together. 2 long years. I mentioned demonic Alice, but that's probably how you would view her too, if you saw her for what she really was. It's strange, because I've avoided thinking about her over the years, and now here she was again. The sleep paralysis would play an important role very soon. Not that I knew it at the time. It was an uneventful day at work, except I couldn't stop thinking about what happened the night before. At work, I talked to my colleague Jack about last night. He told me he has heard about this phenomenon. He said it's called sleep paralysis. It's a state where you cannot move because your mind thinks you're asleep when you're not actually asleep. I decided to research what happened to me after I got home. Maybe there was more information on the internet on how to prevent it. That day, I already had dinner in town and decided to do research as soon as I got home. I wanted to understand what happened.
Thank you.
I had none of the described underlying conditions. I usually sleep well and enough. I don't use any drugs or similar substitutes. Anxious and fearful, maybe. But I don't have any mental conditions that I knew of. Maybe I was just unlucky. I was glad to have found some practical advice. Now, I just had to remember to close my eyes if I have a sleep paralysis again. I vividly recall those dolls from my youth. They were from the most disturbing movie I had seen. I never thought I would be confronted with them again, not even in my wildest dreams. Don't forget this fact, because it's gonna become important very soon. At the time, though, I was just happy that closing my eyes worked. It got rid of everything. Thank you. I told Jack about last night again. After I told him, he became visibly tense. I didn't make much of it at the time. Maybe he knew more than he told me. Maybe he knew what would happen next. After work, we went to a restaurant, and then had drinks at a bar afterwards. That's why I came home later than usual. I decided to research how to make the hallucinations disappear. Maybe there were ways to prevent it altogether. Believe what I had just read. Denial would probably be the best way to describe my reaction to this new information. Maybe those patients were just unlucky. It could be far from the norm. It was an old study after all. I thought about going out before sleeping to catch some fresh air and calm down. I couldn't possibly know what was about to happen that night. The moment I stepped outside, I felt the calm and the coolness of the fresh air. I started to think about what happened during the past few days. Why me? What did I do to deserve this? Should I not have trusted that website? I'm not really going insane, right? Then I began thinking about what the future might hold. Jane Mallowan. What did she do? What did she mean by right choices? So many questions, and yet so few answers. Little did I know, I was about to face my worst fears, and this night would be the last chance to turn it around. Before I'm going to write about what happened next, I want to tell you something about this place. Nothing happening right now made sense to me. My best guess was this is the darkest hour Jane Mellowin was talking about. And one last thing. After I enter one of these doors, there would be no way back.